Could be simply they had to make a quick stop.
And you can only cut back so much, and then you're cutting into meat, not cutting fat.
And that, I guess, was our first clue. There was something going on that we weren't prepared for.
From Halliburton to Cookstown, Minden to Markham, it's VRLand News.
Good afternoon. We have lots to tell you about this Frosty Friday, including a huge fire in Newmarket this morning.
We also get to play with some toys today as the traveling toy chest rolls into our backyard. But first, the weather remains our top story.
What a day for some residents of VRLand. Winds west off Georgian Bay meant more snow squalls to contend with. We've been watching this storm develop on our radar all morning. It's particularly bad in a band that has stayed stationary from north of Parry Sound across to Huntsville. Weather Office says some areas could see up to 30 centimeters every 12 hours. The snow closed all the schools in the East Parry Sound board today and made for some treacherous driving. Cameraman Steve Mansbridge spent the morning on the roads of North VRLand.
Environment Canada says as much as 50 centimeters of snow could fall in the Parry Sound Muskoka region.
It's a little slushy and it could be slippery if they had to make a quick stop. It's changing quite a bit, and there's a lot of black clouds coming in from Georgian Bay, so I think we're going to get the snowfall they're predicting.
It's snowing pretty hard, and we're going to go up there and look after it.
How deep? Any?
A couple inches. Just take your time, and you'll be all right.
How far north is it?
As far as we know, right at the point of barrel.
Wow. The Weather Office says that snow is southbound today as the winds are expected to shift out of the northwest, which means areas from Parry Sound south to Barrie could be next.
Well, the jury is still out in the William Frederick case. They've been deliberating the fate of the convicted cop killer for a day now, and members were sequestered for the night. Frederick wants the right to apply for early parole from his life sentence for killing a Collingwood police officer back in 1977. We'll let you know about the verdict as soon as it comes in. A spectacular fire in a three-story chicken barn in Newmarket early today. The Chester Chicken Farm is one of the largest producers in the province.
Well, we got the call at about 4 to 5 this morning. Two departments responded, Newmarket and Schaumburg, with about 20 firefighters. When the first truck pulled in, we had fire on the first floor of the barn.
Police say the farm owner tried to save some of his prized stock. Early estimates peg the loss at $500,000. It was an ugly Halloween night in Alliston. Three people arrested after 150 kids went on a rampage.
Disturbed me was they were pelting eggs at this older lady with the window down, eh? And, you know, Alliston's a growing town, and they better nip this in the bud.
I do this almost every year for the last 10 years, to go around and see how things are. This year, it's not really any worse than other years, but it's always a chore to get it off, especially the eggs.
We've fared out pretty good this year. We've tripled our manpower strength this year in anticipation of problems, and I think the cold weather has sent the kids home a little early.
Now, a check with other police services in our area showed no major problems, just the usual firecrackers and smashed pumpkins.
Will Ontario's doctors be accepting new patients a week from today? Sharon Burkhardt is here now to look at that question. Sharon.
And patients may not like the answer. Yesterday, after 76% of Ontario's doctors rejected the government's latest offer, they are now threatening to raise the stakes.
So you used the first puffer that I gave you, And then after you've used it, you use the new
one. Morphine?
Okay, you should be using two coppers.
They want to get in to see obstetricians, and they're having babies. They can't get in due to the cutbacks with the government and not having a settlement, and therefore they're screaming at me. Because
my main fear is that I'm not going to have an obstetrician. Even though I'm already booked for one, I still worry about it.
Listen, you want to stand them up and sort of hold them on you there, and then you won't be quite as nervous, okay?
And that job action may be just the start, with government and doctors still far apart.
I won't be paid to do it, and nobody wants to work for free. I would vote for this agreement. First of all, I think we need to have sacrosanct that you cannot dictate to graduating physicians in this province that they have to go to some other community. That's just totally inequitable and unfair.
Okay, so we need to book Jared's two-year needle?
That big stumbling block would force new doctors into underserviced areas like Alliston, where Health Minister Jim Wilson is from. He's taking the weekend there to decide whether he'll even go back to the bargaining table. If not, most Ontario doctors will stop seeing new patients by November 8th, and some will go even further.
We have voted to move the elective surgical list and deferred into the future, perhaps to the new fiscal year when the government can fund their treatment.
Won't that hurt patients, though?
In the long term, it's our patients that we're trying to help here.
And then just bundle his arm in there, what's inside your other arm, okay?
So let's get back to the table and work out a deal that works for both sides, that we can provide the care that Ontario people deserve in 1996.
Doctors also say many of them are so frustrated more and more are heading to the U.S., and that just means more and more shortages in our healthcare system. But whether or not patients believe the doctors are really fighting for them is going to be put to the test if more and more of them start taking job action. Michelle.
Sharon, when do we know that?
Well, when we see if the talks are back on, and that probably is something that we should know by early next week.
Thanks very much, Sharon. No conclusion yet to that story, but there is a resolution in the Richmond Hill condo controversy.
The champagne, I can bring all my important papers that I took away and all my valuable possessions and bring them back.
Yes. Did you actually move out of the building?
It was like a Christmas present on Halloween for residents. A judge has ruled in their favor by lifting the town's eviction notice. So residents can remain as work is done to shore up the foundation damaged by an underground aquifer. The condo board may sue the town.
Big news today out of Detroit about airbags. The big three automakers are changing the bags in Canadian vehicles to ones that deploy with less force. And they'll send you a warning if you already have a passenger side airbag in your vehicle. The device can kill and injure children as they deploy at speeds up to 320 kilometers an hour.
That life continues to exist on Mars, and therefore that this meteorite would have recorded the presence of life on Mars.
And now for some strong evidence that there was once life on Mars. British scientists have found organic matter in two meteorites, actual life forms. Wow.
It's amazing, and of course they're millions and billions of years old.
Oh, I can't even fathom. Well, they see just one little tiny peck, and from that they build it all back.
I know. It's beyond me. I'm not a scientist.
X-Files, baby.
Yeah. Got an incredible story coming up. It's a trip to a home sweet.
And the spraying, it was...
Sounds pretty creepy.
It was an eerie experience.
Inside the walls of this century-old home in Orillia, liters and liters of honey. It's a complete surprise to the family renovating the house. We'll meet them later.
And weather-wise, that picture's deceiving. Windy, cold, and more of the white stuff coming up this weekend. Details when we come back.
On a day like today, I'm happy our producer decided to keep me inside and send Shane out into the freezing cold. Shane, how cold is it out there?
It is so cold. Okay, I don't have a punchline, but yeah, it's cold out here. We saw the wind blowing when Sharon was on earlier. She talked about the doctors. It is real cold. Wind's gusting to about 50 clicks, and it looks like it's going to stay that way over the weekend. Let's take a look outside on our George and Pontiac Buick Tower Camp. Temperature right now sitting at 1 degree, but with the wind, it feels a lot cooler than that. Winds are gusting from 19 to 30 clicks, and I think they've even picked up in the last half hour. They are out of the west. Relative humidity, And there you see it sitting at around just a little over 60%. The barometric pressure is steady. Okay, this afternoon forecast, Parry Sound and Haliburton, flurries, windy, a high of zero. There is a snow squall warning in effect for the Parry Sound and Muskoka area. And as we go to Muskoka, Huronia, we can show you again the snow squall warning for Parry Sound and a snow squall advisory for northern Huronia. It will be cloudy, windy, flurries, and a high of two, but like I say, it won't feel like that. York region and Dufferin, mostly cloudy, windy, cold, isolated flurries, and a high of 2 degrees. Okay, for tonight, Parry Sound, Haliburton, flurries and snow squalls continuing, a low of minus two. Muskoka, Huronia, carbon copy, flurries, more snow squalls, and a low of minus two as well. York region and Dufferin, all of a sudden the nice spots, mainly cloudy and windy, low of minus one. Who would have thought that that would have been the nice spot? Tomorrow, Parry Sound, Haliburton, as we start the weekend, flurries, snow squalls, windy and cold, a high of 0 degrees. Muskoka and Huronia, cloudy, flurries, snow squalls, windy, high of 0 degrees. Man, what an ugly looking weekend. York region and Dufferin, mainly cloudy, scattered flurries and a high of one. Let's go long range, see if things improve at all. Cloudy, flurries, windy, cold, high of zero, doesn't look good there. Let's try Monday. Partly cloudy, not so cold, and a high of 6 degrees, not bad. And Tuesday, mainly cloudy with showers, and a high of 11 degrees. Normals for this time of year are 1 and 9 degrees. Okay, so as we said, we talked about the weather. It is cold. You can see the flurry activity starting right here, and we are in southern Huronia. We are now making our way over to the traveling toy chest, my kind of thing.
And Michelle, I've got the parka on. I've been in VRLand long enough. Forget the fashion. Go for the warmth.
I'm always styling.
Come on inside. Okay. They're doing some great stuff here. This is the traveling toy chest. Kids are playing, and we'll be talking all about it when we come back.
And now the camera's back on.
Well, we're inside the traveling toy chest now, having a great time with the toys here. And Lynn Grennan runs the van. Why do we take toys on the road, Lynn?
Just different communities where the parents can't go out to resource centers or whatever, so we go out to meet the families.
So instead of going to a nursery school or whatever, it's available on the road?
Yep, so I can go to any neighborhood and stop in someone's driveway and service the families.
And where? How many places do you go to?
57 throughout the month, throughout Simcoe County.
You're a busy girl.
Yeah.
Okay, and you've got a wide variety of toys for them too here. Tell us about that.
We service children from 0 to 10. We also have a selection of toys for children with special needs.
You do? Mm-hmm. Now, and I understand as well that the van is run by the District Association for Kids with Special Needs.
We're operated by the Barron District Association for People with Special Needs, and we're funded by the Community of Ministry and Social Services.
Okay. Shane, let's talk to these kids.
I'm back. Excuse me. Hi, everybody.
It's tight quarters here in the van.
I'm back. It was a little tight. I saw that someone wanted to play with my dinosaur, but it's still okay. Obviously, kids seem to be having a great time.
Oh, they do. They love it. They come here to the play group, and every month they get new toys, and they love it.
And you don't have to go up and buy toys, hey. Obviously. They have a chance to play with the newest, the greatest.
That's it. Little Tykes, Fisher Price, you name it. They got it.
Hey, now, you've been very busy. You've been playing with the barn. What's your favorite part of the toy room, buddy? I'm talking to you.
What's your favorite animal?
Can you make a sound for us?
Where's
it? Nay! Moo! I can make the sounds. I have a lot of experience playing with toys.
I believe the door makes the sound, if it's anything like my daughter.
Yeah.
Dinosaurs. Everything.
There you go.
You name it.
You've
got
your moo sound out here.
Now, Lynn, there's a number of people can call if they want to have this service come to their neighborhood.
They can call the toy chest at 726-0701.
Okay.
Open up, let me in! Open up, let me in!
You've got an expert there.
It's raining, I'm wearing leather.
What would you recommend for great Christmas toys? I mean, you've been able to borrow all the stuff. What are these guys getting for Christmas?
Well, Cabbage Patch for this one, and the, what's for him? Oh, the little garage for all the cars.
Oh, yes.
Oh, love the garage with the cars.
With the ramp, the whole bit.
Oh, cool.
What do you recommend for Shane? We're always shopping
yeah,
for him.
I'm always looking for a new toy.
Sharp tooth.
All right. I don't think, can you see if he fits in the barn?
Oh,
3,000, okay. More than 3,000 toys in total, is that correct?
That's right.
Unbelievable. And you stop once a month in communities, you go more often?
Just once a month in each community. We also have a toy library in Barrie at 190 Cook Street, which has a playroom and more toys to borrow.
Great. I visited that one, the toy chest. Kids love it.
Oh, great.
Okay, we've got sports coming up.
Okay, coming up, we are going to switch gears from the barnyard, and we will head to Long Island as we check out the Islanders and the Leafs. A busy night in the NHL. Highlights when we come back.
Scores. That's what he does so well, Howie. Sundin is... Aha! Green will draw against Kirk.
Warming up a little.
Freezing out there.
A lot more room around us, too.
Yeah, but it doesn't have as many toys.
I know.
It's not the same.
They won't give him the dinosaur he asked, but they
wouldn't. No, you got to sign him out and leave a deposit or something crazy like that.
Let's go on to sports, shall we?
Very busy day in the NHL, busy night, and we'll get right to it. Now, if the Toronto Maple Leafs have any hopes of making the playoffs this year, they're going to have to beat the teams that are below them in the standings. Now, earlier this week, they had a terrible third period. They fell apart and lost to the LA Kings. Last night, they ventured to Long Island to take on the Islanders, and another team they've got to beat. Let's go to some of the action from this one, and the Leafs get on the board first in the first. Matt Sundin, beautiful shot, fakes, uses Jamie McCowan as a screen, and it's 1-0 TO in the first. Fans celebrating Halloween. Let's go to the second period, and you don't even see this one right off the draw. You just see the back of the net behind Ponfat. 1-1 as Zygmunt Palfy rips one past Ponfat, and then just about 35 seconds later, it's the big guy again, Zygmunt Palfy, left alone in front. Right there, he wires it past Ponfat. It's 2-1 Islanders. Could the Leafs be falling apart? Second period, after Mike Murphy calls a timeout to kind of gather the troops, Mike Craig picks up his own rebound, shovels it past Eric Fichaud, the former Leaf, and we are tied at 2-2. And then still in the second period, this guy, they are counting on a lot this season with Mike Gartner gone and Dave Vanderchuk on. There you see Sergei Berezin left alone in front, yawning cage, he scores. Leafs go on to win this one 5-3. Let's go to Boston now. Bruins and the Whalers will pick this one up in the first period. No score. Bruins can't clear the zone. Paul Ranheim gets two whacks at it. He finally beats right there. It gets by Billy Ranford, and it is 1-0 Whalers. Second period, and the Whale go up by a pair, and this guy doesn't score much. Mark Jansen, he's left alone in front, and he doesn't make a mistake here. Bang, past Ranford, and it's 2-0 for Hartford. Still in the second, Boston would finally get on the board, and it is a beautiful pass by Adam Oates. This guy's a great playmaker, and this is why he takes the puck. See Steve Hines all alone in front. He redirects it in 2-1 for the Whalers, and again in the second period, the Bruins would tie it up, and this guy's been doing it for years. Ricky Tocchet, he will just bury it from in front of the net right there, and we are tied at 2. Bruins up, third straight goal. Adam Oates on the wraparound, and you got to watch this. Watch the moves, the patience. He gets it behind the net, spins, turns, fires into the cage. 3-2 for the Bruins. Scoring not over, though, in the period. Andrew Cashel is able to beat Ranford. This game ends in a 3-3 tie. Okay, our next stop is going to be Tampa Bay Lightning and the Flyers, and we're going to get to that game. There you go. There you see. First period, Brian Bradley opens the scoring. He beats Ronnie Hextall, and it is 1-0 T-Bay. Tampa would go up by a pair a little later on in the first. Dino Cicerelli, this guy, man, he's ageless. He's been playing forever. He gets two whacks at it. His own rebound, though, he would finally put in. Hextall having all kinds of trouble in the first period. Tampa Bay would lead this one 3-0, but the Flyers storm back for the big 4-3 win. Okay, big night on the new VR tonight. The Toronto Shooting Stars, the indoor soccer team, having a little bit of trouble in the front office, looking to the league for some help, but the team will play tonight. They take on another new team, the Edmonton Drillers. Game time, 7 o'clock at Maple Leaf Gardens. Kevin Quinn will have the call. You can catch all the action right here live at the new VR, starting at, as mentioned, 7 o'clock. Also tonight, Raptors open up their second NBA season. They are at home to Patrick Ewing and the New York Knicks. Should be an exciting season for the Raptors. Once again, all the action throughout the season pretty much here on the new VR, except tonight, of course. And on the local sports front, Newmarket 87s improved their season start to 16-0. Yesterday, they dumped Stouffville 6-3, an unbelievable start, a record start for them. One other score to tell you about, Aurelia dumped Collingwood 7-4 in Junior A action. Great night on the ice last
Definitely.
Night.
Definitely. Thanks, Shane. We'll check in with Janie Robinson now, looking at the VRLand News at 6.
And Michelle, we're going to stay in the court for the jury's decision into the early parole of a Collingwood cop killer. And we're busting crime with cops tonight, too. On the Storm Watch at 6, we find out if resorts are ready for the snow to stay here in ski country. Now, as Shane mentioned, there's going to be a big game on the new VR tonight at 7. We're going to be live from Maple Leaf Gardens with our Kevin Quinn to get you ready for that game. We're also going to get you ready for the weekend here in VRLand tonight, too. So join us at 6. Now it's back to Shane and Michelle.
Thanks, Janie. Well, many people who buy old houses and renovate them find lots of surprises, but this one's very unusual.
The Van Sinclairs discovered a massive beehive, and as Roger Klein found out, it is a honey of a deal.
Lewis has gone to get more chemical. This is a big job.
I bet you.
And they're angry bees.
The small bedroom underneath the window there, we could see bees buzzing around on the ledge. So we took the ball out from there, and the hive started underneath the window and went right down basically to the basement.
So you had the pest control people coming, and what did they think of it when they first saw it?
Well, the first one was a national company who just came and shook their heads and walked away and said, this job's way too big for us. And that, I guess, was our first clue. There was something going on that we weren't prepared for. So when we opened up the wall finally and got to them, the buzz, the noise, you could hear it outside. It was just eerie. And the smell of the honey coming at you at the same time, and all this mass of living things and the spraying, it was...
Sounds pretty creepy.
It was an eerie experience.
There are all sorts of insects that could be living in your house right now. Cluster flies, ladybugs, things like that. But how would you like to have over 100,000 honeybees living in your walls for years and years, building a beautiful comb of honey? What a wonderful byproduct. In Aurelia, Roger Klein, VRLand News.
Oh, man.
That's right. The silver lining in the cloud, I guess. The sound of the bees.
That
That's
would
spooky.
Be scary. That
I once had an scary. Apartment that carpenter ants invaded. I came home one day and opened my bedroom door, and they were all over the walls.
See,
I ran.
Could you
I
live there afterwards? I'd be scared. I hate bugs.
That's you, Shane. You're from the city.
Exactly.
Tell us about the weather.
Oh, I hate to even tell you. Like we say, snow squall warning for the northern part, Parry Sound, Muskoka. Northern part of Huronia, snow squall advisory. And pretty much throughout the weekend, lots of cold weather, a lot of very strong winds, which makes drifting snow possible if it continues to come. If you're on the highway, take care. Yeah. Things will warm up once we start a new week. We talked about showers possibly on Monday or Tuesday with a high of 11 degrees. So warm weather is in the works.
Do take it easy and have a great weekend.
Shooting stars.
Shooting stars tonight. We'll see you on Monday.
Have a great day.